Caylee was not Casey's first pregnancy. She has been pregnant before. Don't know the year. Apparently she was probably sexually active from junior high on up. In the letters between the two sisters, one of which is Cindy's mother, Shirley. I'm doing some quotes now. Cindy is going to have to get tough around there. She needs to let Casey and George know the free ride is over. Who knows? Maybe the alimony she would have to give him would be less than what it is costing her to have him live there. She ought to check that out. Keep me updated, said the aunt, the great aunt. Keep me updated as to what's going on with her. If she needs a no-interest loan, I could help her out and would be glad to, as long as George is out of there. If you want to mention this to her, do so. Then June 9th. Then on July 8th, I am with you, thinking something must be amiss with Caylee. Mind you, she's been missing for, what would that be, 3 weeks. I can't believe that she would be that upset to speak to and to hear her grandmother on the phone. Just home. That little girl is okay. I just hope that that little girl is okay. I wonder how much of Caylee's clothes and toys Casey took when she left. How much of her own things did she take? ? Seems to me they would be running out of things to wear. But already these two sisters, this was only a few days afterwards, and they right away started being suspicious. They got the message. The deal that Casey tells about sounds fishy to me. At least she does have the baby with her and is not expecting Cindy to care for Caylee. And then on July 18th, Cindy Anthony's mother, Shirley, emails the family the news. Something about that Cindy wrote her brother. You know, he was increasingly, at first he was very polite, but then he started getting angry at her stonewalling and sidestepping his question on the ghost babysitter. And Cindy replies, "I've told you, you do not know the facts. You are so fixated on the sitter. Get over this sitter. Just because I have no pictures of the sitter doesn't mean she doesn't exist." Does that remind you of it? Science. What's science? Science means nothing. Thing. The link that I've got on the right-hand side, it's 50 pages of email correspondence between the two sisters. And it is a very long download, but it's worth it. You just start at number one and just read on through. George's second marriage ended in divorce. I've lost my link on this, but anyway, the divorce was due to his chronic lying. On Cindy's enemy list to the memorial, included at least five media. So this was her way of controlling the media, I suppose, is to threaten them, you know, learning from politicians. No interviews unless you do, you kowtow to me. George's date of birth. I understand there's been a big, huge document dump of 1,000 documents, or 1,000 pages. Cannot wait to see it. Anyway, George's date of birth is, his middle name is Arthur, incidentally. George Arthur Anthony. And his date of birth is September 5th, 1951. And he ran for some small office in, clerk of court or something in their county, and he didn't win, of course. But, you know, that would be a perfect job for George. There's no work involved, you know? Politics. Extremely lazy people. I'm looking through, I'm making sure that I don't have... the dead giveaway of Cindy Anthony's personality was when... she expected law enforcement to come to her house every day and report to her. Quote, "You guys were so good the first 4 days, and then you were, you know, no good." She severed ties with law enforcement as soon as they wanted to ask her follow-up questions, meaning she could not withstand the questioning due to the absurdity of her alibi story. Law enforcement refused to kowtow to Cindy. You know, people who are so wrapped up in themselves really do not have much capacity to love. And that's what I see in this entire family. All this family solidarity and stuff is it's I don't see much in the way of love. You can't love somebody you don't respect, and people that you feel sorry for, you know, let's face it, there are some people that walk around life with a kick me sign on their forehead. And what should be there should be, don't even think about it. Anyway, I'm going to go and start looking for the new document dump and see what's in there.